blessings to every one of you.
Yes, Lord.
You took the nails for me. You took the for that day at Calvary. You had the power to save yourself, but you thought of me instead. And oh, what a sacrifice to freely lay down your so my soul wouldn't be lost. You paid the cost.
Blessings to everyone. Good day to you all that is watching and tuning in from different places, different country, different states. This is Evangelist Emmanuel Emeka Okeke in the prophetic department. I want to say a big thank you to all of you that are tuning in right now, all of you that are watching live right now, all of you that are watching this video live right now. All of you that are watching it, may God bless you, may God increase you, may God take you from one dimension to the next dimension. I believe that what you're about to learn today is going to be powerful. I'm not going to take much of your time, but what you're going to learn today is going to be very, very powerful, and it's going to be something that you're going to have to share. Once again, it's Evangelist Emmanuel Emeka Okeke in the prophetic department. There are a lot of things that a lot of you have been asking why I stopped making videos. I didn't actually stop making videos. I have to go into research and studying. And hearing from my father, knowing if I should do certain kind of videos or not do certain kind of videos, it's very, very important to hear from God. So you don't put a video out there that will mislead or misguide people out there. It's always good to make your researches and verify the authenticity of what you're about to share out there. You don't want to share out the video and let that come and say that the video you shared was wrong. What about the people that have actually watched it? So it's very, very important. Thank you all for watching right now. Thank you for every one of you that have been supporting us, sharing these videos, spreading the good news of God. Every one of you that are doing the work of Christ, preaching the gospel, using your social media platform to spread the gospel and preach the gospel. I want to tell you guys that none of this effort is going to waste. God is blessing you in ways you don't even know. So every one of you that are evangelists, prophets, apostles, teachers, and pastors that are through men of God, may God bless you, may God increase you. And those of you that are wanting to evangelize and preach the gospel of God, your hunger is in you. Start doing it. Some of you want to that when you reach a certain way, that you want to get to a certain knowledge, a certain powerful knowledge before you start preaching. No, start with the little you know and start speaking to someone that you know more better than, you know, you chip in the idea to them and, you know, that's just how it goes. Now, I want to talk about how demons comes into someone's life. There are so many ways a demon can come into someone's life. See, the problem that we have is that most people say, most people go for deliverance. Now, after deliverance, they will say, today I got healed of, the man of God cured my cancer and everything is gone. Then after 2 weeks, the cancer came back. That means the man of God is not real. No, that's not true. That's not the truth. You see, the Bible made us understand very clearly that if a demon is cast out, the demon goes to the desert. And if he can't stay, he comes back. He said, let me return. He said, I will return to the home where I was chased out from. And when he returns to that home, I find that home clean, kept, well cleaned, well dressed, well furnished. And there is nobody living there. You can bring in 7 more demons that are stronger than it was and possess that person. And that means that the person's situation will be worse than it was before. So there are things that I want to share with you on how demons can come in. I'll try my possible best to explain this in the best way I can. Now, how do demons come in? Now let's take a look at the book of Exodus 23-5. Book of Exodus 23-5. I'm reading it by NLT, my favorite Bible this thing. You must not have any other God but me. Now, God said you must, this is the law, this is God speaking. You must not have any other God but me. So, whenever you value anything more than God, there's that you have opened a room to a demon to manifest. Whenever there is any opening, for example, now the Bible said you can't love God and love money. So, if you start loving money, then you have opened room for the demon to possess you, for a demon to possess you. So whatever you love more than God is a sin. And whatever that is a sin opens room for a demon to possess you. Okay? Now, that's number one. You must not have any other God but me. Now, what are gods? It's not just about the idol you worship. If you value even your boyfriend more than God himself, he becomes a god. Whatever you value more than God, whatever you give more attention to, if I value my Facebook account more than God, then automatically my Facebook is my God. And that is a sin. That is a sin. That is a sin. That is a sin. So you have to learn it. You must not make for yourself an idol of any kind. You see, we have some people that make idols. You know, they worship dolls. Some people worship. Some people bring the pictures of Jesus Christ. Yes. They say that is not the picture of Jesus Christ. That is the person that acted as Jesus Christ in a particular movie. They bring out the person's picture and they post it and they bow to it. That is wrong. The Bible is saying this in the book of Exodus 23-4. Verse 4 is saying, you must not make for yourself an idol of any kind. Or an image of anything in heaven, that is even including him, an image of anything in heaven, or on earth, or in the sea. So whatever image you make and you bow to it, whatever image you make, be it an image of cross that you make and you bow to it, is a sin. And it opens room to demons of religion to come and possess you. It opens rooms to demons to possess you. You must not bow down to them or worship them. The Bible says you must not bow down. Bow down to them is a different thing. Worship is a different thing. Say you must not bow down to them. No matter what, be it the crucifix, be it the picture of Jesus Christ, you must not come and bow down to it or worship it. It is wrong. It opens room for the demon to manipulate you. You see, the 3 ways that the devil works is deception. The devil deceives you, then manipulates you, then he controls you. These are the 3 ways the devil works. He deceives you, telling you, there's nothing wrong. This is the image of Jesus Christ. Bow to it. Not knowing that the image you're bowing to is not Jesus Christ. Because there was no photograph of Jesus Christ then. So the image you're bowing to is the image of a man that acted in a movie. And you bow to that image. Whoa. Now you are worshipping a man already, automatically. So when you bow down to that, you're opening room. The devil will tell you, he's Jesus Christ now, just worship him. God knows you're worshiping him. Bow to it, and you bow to him. Remember what Jesus Christ, when the devil tempted Jesus Christ, he said, bow to me and I'll give you all this. So whenever you bow to anything, you have surrendered to that thing. You have surrendered to the will of the devil. Okay? God is everywhere. You don't necessarily need to see God to bow to him. You can just bow in faith, knowing that you're bowing to the King of Kings, but not to anything. Praise the Lord Jesus. Thank you, Father. You must not bow down to them or worship them. For I, the Lord your God, I am a jealous God who will not tolerate your affection for any other gods. I lay the sins of the parents upon the children. Now, if any of you, now these are the ways demons come in. Now, if any of you have worshipped any idol, bowed to any idol, loved anything more than God, automatically there's a curse in your generation. You know now, I will always tell you the truth. I go straight I go very hard. Most people say that I'm too straight up to the core. But yeah, that is it. I'll go very hard, and I'll tell you the whole truth, because there's not like a little truth. Is that the whole truth or not the truth? It's not like a little part of the truth. No, you go all in, the whole truth. Sorry about my voice. It happens after hosting videos. I'm gonna find a remedy to that. So he said, you are fetch of any good. I lay the sins of the person upon their children. The sin will go from their children. From their children. The entire family is affected. The entire family, the lineage, entire family is affected. Even children in the third and fourth generation of those who reject me, So if I reject God, if I worship anything other than God, if I bow to any image, automatically my children will pay the price. My generation to the third and fourth generation will pay the price. They will suffer dearly. That means I will suffer. My children will suffer. Their children will suffer, and their children will suffer, and their children will suffer. The first generation. And if any of the children in between worship an idol again, it will start from beginning again, start from number one and keep going down. It's good you understand this. Most churches deviate from preaching this. So bowing down to anything is wrong. Now, how do you break curses? This is what I'm teaching my mentorship class. I posted a link about people to join the mentorship class, and a lot of people find it hard to join the mentorship class. The very people that find the mentorship class, a lot of things are being revealed to them. You see, the reason why we made the mentorship class like that is because I've created a lot of groups, so many groups on WhatsApp, and we find out some people don't take things seriously. They don't join the group, they don't take it serious. They get it too easy. They don't feel like, I have this man number, I can always talk to the evangelist anytime I want. So they don't value it. They don't value it because they have your number, they don't value it. They prefer that they can always call you. And that is why I'm trying to organize everything. If you really want to be set free, there's a price to pay. Not finances, there's a price to pay. And that price is determination. Determination is the hardest price to pay. Discipline is the hardest price to pay. You must discipline yourself. It's very, very important. In fact, it's the most important thing when you want to serve God. Disciplining yourself is the most important thing if you must serve God. Praise the Lord Jesus. I'm going to be stopping there for today. Now, there are so many ways that demons can come in. We have a list of demons. Let me see. Now, let me give you the list of demons when it has to do with fear. These are demons. The fear of death is a spirit. If you have the fear of death in you, if you're always scared that you might die, the spirit of death is in you. It's a demon. It's a spirit on itself. The spirit of death is in you. You see yourself feel like jumping and committing suicide. There is a demon. It's not your fault. There is a demon that is possessing you. I'll make a video that will explain how these demons come in, because I'm trying to watch my time. Or I'll be live so you can watch it. The fear of death is a demon. Fear of rejection is a spirit on itself. Fear of rejection, you always are scared because you've tried before, you rejected. You fear that people reject you. People don't want you. You're not attractive. You're not beautiful. People are rejecting you. It's a demon. Once you sense that in your body, go for deliverance. There's a spirit in you. Rebuke that spirit or go for deliverance. Or call someone to pray for you. Fear of the dark. When you are scared of the dark, there is no light. You are scared. You're looking for someone to hold you. There's a spirit presence. There is a demon presence. Go for deliverance. Fear of confined space. I think they call it claustrophobia or something. Fear of confined space, when you're in a little space, maybe you're in the kitchen is small, you feel like you can't breathe. It used to happen to me, I have to cast it away. I have to go for deliverance and cast it away. So it's very important. Fear of open space. Some people, when they're in the open, they feel they're afraid. They are scared. I don't know why they are scared, but they're in the open. They feel like, oh my God, people are touching them too much. Don't like people looking at them too much. There is a demon in charge of that. It's a spirit. It's a demon on itself. And even see, when I say a demon, an evil spirit, it is the same thing. A demon and an evil spirit is the same thing. The fear of the wind. Some people are scared of wind. Is a demon. Any sense of fear in you is a demon. Then we have a fear of failure. You believe that you're gonna fail this. You failed the first one, the first second time. The spirit now comes in and dwells out of you. Once you sense the fear of failure, you stop trying things out. You say, there's no point of trying it out, still fail. That is the fear of failure. Fear of disappointment. You know, you dated one person, disappointed one person, disappoint you. You only feel that never is going to disappoint you. That is a spirit. You need to be delivered from it. It's a spirit. Fear of disappointment is a spirit. The fear of women. There are people that are scared of women. I used to be scared of women when I was growing up. You know, because I've heard so many stories about them. Delilah, Jezebel, you know, when I was growing up, I was told so many stories about women. And I got scared of them, you know, I was scared of them, but God set me, God set me free from it. And I lost that feeling left, that demon left, you know. The fear of men, some people are scared of men. How can some people be scared of men? Let's, for example, when you are growing up, you see your father beating your mother always, and you're a girl, you see your father beating your mother always, and you end up hating men just like that. You grow up with the fear of men. It's a demon. Fear of animals. People are scared of different kind of animals. Some people are scared of cockroach. These are spirits. It's not just a natural thing. These are spirits. These are demonic spirits. And you notice whenever you fear it, the devil will always prey on you through your weakness. So when you fear cockroach, you start seeing cockroach in your dream. The devil uses it to manipulate your dream. I'm trying to rush up because of time. Fear of objects. Some people fear of objects. I don't know why. Fear of heights. I used to be scared of heights too, but God has conquered that for me. Fear of heights. Whenever you're staying in an upstairs, or you climb a tree, or you are in a certain height, you're scared. You be in a plane, you're having phobia for it. You're scared of it. That is a spirit. You have to cast it out. It's a spirit. And as long as that spirit remains there, you keep having revelation and dreams when you're on a high place, so that the devil manipulates you, get delivered from it. Then fear of length. Some people are afraid of anything that is long. Length, you know. You look at something, a tree, so high, you get scared. Why is this tree so high? Someone is taller than you, just get somehow around the person. That is fear. Cast it out. Loud noise. Fear of loud. Some people are scared of loud noise. Everybody is loud. I mean, some people don't like. There's a difference between not liking loud noise and being scared of loud noise. Where something you just get scared. Oh my God. Oh my God. You have to start pumping faster. Scared of loud noise. Fear of blood. I used to be scared of blood. I used to be scared of blood. When I was small, I liked watching movies where there's a lot of killing and blood like that. Then one day someone told me that it is wrong for you to be, liking blood. It is wrong. You shouldn't be doing that. Then I started saying, okay, I should be scared of blood, man. I started acting to be scared of blood. Then before I know, the spirit came inside of me and I started being scared of blood, really. But then again, God delivered me from it. Fear of order. So people don't like anything to be kept in a good order. So we don't like anything to be kept in a good order. You understand? So people don't like anything. Whenever they come to a certain place and the place is arranged, they feel like, oh no. They like scattering things. These are fear of order. They don't like. So we don't like. It can also mean that people don't like discipline. So people don't like discipline. They want anything to just be anyhow. Fear of subject. Now, etc. There are so many kinds of fear. These are the ones I'm able to share for you. But remember, you can conquer the spirit. You can read the book of 2 Timothy 1, verse 7. When you read it, you understand a lot of things. How you can conquer. Because God has not given the spirit of fear, but the spirit of boldness, the spirit of power, the spirit of authority, and the spirit of hope. So don't ever be scared of anything, alright? I'm going to be ending this video now because it's long enough. And I pray for every one of you that you're having the spirit of fear. I come against every spirit of fear in your life. I break every spirit of fear in your life. I rebuke every spirit of fear in your life. Jesus Christ has set you free. So whatever power, whatever channel that the devil has opened in order to possess you, whatever, Jesus Christ said that in him, our weakness is made strong. So thereby I begin to speak into your life. He said in the book of Job, we shall decree your word shall come to pass. Thereby I speak and I decree into your life that whatever weakness that the devil has opened in your life, whatever door that the devil has opened in order for him to channel and bring forth deception and bring forth manipulation and bring forth control, may that door be closed now in your life in the name of Jesus Christ. In Jesus' name I pray. For those of you that are having the spirit of fear, I rebuke the spirit of fear in the name of Jesus. Every spirit of fear, I rebuke it in the name of Jesus. Let the fire of the Holy Ghost cast away those fears. Every spirit of fear, right now, I command you to catch fire in the name of Jesus. Whatever demon, you demon, I speak to you, you demon, right now, hear the word of the Lord in the name of Jesus. For the book of Luke 9 verse 1 said that God has given us the authority, has given me the authority, has given me the power to cast out all demons, to heal all diseases. So whatever spirit that is in you, whatever spirit that is in you, be it blood pressure, whatever demon that is in you, whatever spirit of fear that is in you, whatever channel the devil has opened this morning, whatever demon that is possessing you or oppressing you right now, I command you to catch fire in the name of Jesus. And I rebuke you and I reject and I cast you away, never to return in the name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name. I'll be making a video praying specifically for those that are having certain kind of demons challenge. I'm making a video. It might be a 10 minutes to 20 minutes video. Don't fail to watch it. Watch it. It will change your life. It will improve your life. It will take you to a new dimension and like Christ. And I bless everyone of you that is watching. May God bless you. May God increase you. I'm sorry I talk very fast. It's just because of time. I don't want it to be up to 20 minutes. So God bless you. Remember to share this video. Share this video. Share this video. Follow me on my handles at Instagram at Evangelist Emmanuel Okeke. And subscribe to our page. And you should be in a mentorship class. God bless you. In Jesus' name. Thank you for our sponsors and partners. May God bless you. Amen.